Be right there. So there's someone higher. Present. Dick Gumshoe. You're her lawyer, right, pal? If you got business here, you'd better do it quick. He thinks I'm Maya's lawyer. Examine, man! Examine! See. The sky is blue and so am I. Eh? There's that hotel right across the way. Yeah. Plant. Mia's favorite part of Plant. I remember it had this bizarre name no one could ever remember. Cordyline Stricter. Pal. What? Who was that? An old movie poster. Apparently this was the first movie that made Mia cry when she saw it. I have to check it out on... Yeah, blah. There's a horrendous amount of legal books here. Scarier still is that Mia probably read all of these. What's this? Perfectly clean desk. Phone. Okay, going back. Move. No, back. Talk. Let's talk to him. Talk about Mia, let's go. About Miss Faye, did you do an autopsy? You want to know the results, eh? No, don't you look at me like that, pal. It's no use. She might have been your boss, but that doesn't mean you get any special treatment. Alright. You can see the report. But that's all. Ooh! We got some evidence. Maya said she came at 9. Well, she was still warm. Single blunt force trauma. Death was instantaneous. Not bleeding to death like the other guy. Girl. Okay. Let's talk about Maya. About Maya. I'm looking forward to the trial. Sorry, pa, but this is one trial you aren't going to win. Why do you say that? The city's put Prosecutor Edgeworth on the prosecution. I'm sure you know what that means. You being a lawyer and all. Prosecutor Edgeworth. That's right, pal. Mr. Miles Edgeworth himself. Wait. You do know him, don't you? Meh. If I say I do, he will catch me lying right-handed. Wait a second. Do I have a court record from him? No. Never heard of him. And you call yourself a lawyer. About 4 years ago, this Edgeworth guy became a prosecutor at the age of 20. Everyone says he's a genius. Well, Mia said I'm a genius too, so... Everyone says he's a genius, surprised you don't know him. Of course I know him, I was just playing dumb. He's a cold, heartless machine who'll do anything to get a guilty verdict. There are rumors of back alley deals and forged evidence. All I know for sure is that Edgeworth hates crime with enormous abnormal passion. Never imagined I'd be facing him so soon. Okay. Let's move to the Grossberg Law Offices. According to the receptionist, the big boss is out. She couldn't say when he'd be back. It must be hard to keep track of everything when you're a famous lawyer. Not to mention run an office like this. I guess I'll just have to come back later. But first, we'll take a look around. Examine. Gather information. Let's go. He's smoking. A table for clients. Elegant evening case, and if I'm not mistaken, that lighter's made of solid gold. Even I can tell someone here's got money to burn. Yep. Same plant. An expensive potted plant. No idea what kind of plant it is, but it's probably the most expensive one available. The painting has been bugging me ever since I stepped in here. The oil paint is so thick, it's practically giving me a stuffed nose. Sure, the price is nothing to sneeze at either, for that matter. Possible. Solid mahogany desk. The wood's been polished to a deep luster. Okay. What else can we gather in information? Mahogany bookshelves. Looks like crap. Expensive looking books. They don't look like they've been ever read. Yeah. That's it, I guess. Isn't it? Yeah. That's it. Okay. Move. Detention center. Oh, we can go back there. Maybe they're still there. Maybe they're not. Can we talk to him? To some... No. Did you see my face cell phone? Oh, that? I have that. Do you think you could give it back? Sure. I mean, wait a second. Tricky lawyer. Tell him straight that there's a conversation recorded on it. Tell him not so straight. Not so straight means not lying, but not telling the truth, right? Let's tell him straight. Oh, no, it's just, you know, detective. Nope. I know nothing, pal. That cell phone has a lot of numbers on it. Like a boyfriend's. Cell phone holds a little girl's sweetest and spicy secrets. You're trying to confuse me? Sorry, pal. I already checked all the numbers in memory. Impressive. You're quite the detective. Oh, here, you can have the phone back. There weren't any suspicious call records in there, after all. Seems you didn't notice. Yes. Check the court record to hear the recorded conversation, I guess. I've asked all the questions I need to. You all done, pal? Yeah. Oh, wait. I don't suppose you're planning on talking to that witness. Anyway, you'd better not. No influencing the witness with your lawyerly ways, pal. What's loyally ways? Come to think of it. The witness. Yeah. Miss April May. So Maya, Mia, and May. Sorry about this, but I can't tell you anything about her. April, May, okay. Well, May, April. So you've sent her home already then? You're trying to lawyer tricks on me now. She's not to go outside her room until her trial. So she's still in the hotel across the way. I guess I should know better than to try to get a detective lead information. You got that right, pal. Okay, let's go. Wait. No. Let's move to Gatewater Hotel. Let's see. Ohayou gozaimasu! Well, hello there, handsome. Aye. Smooth ride, real smooth. You're the lawyer, aren't you? The detective told me. He said, don't say nothing to that lawyer, pal. Tee-hee. Meme to self. Thank Detective Gumshoe for making my job harder. Gee, this is all like something out of a movie. It's also exciting. I can hardly contain myself. Me neither. Oh, let me go freshen up so I can look the... So I can look the part of the beautiful eyewitness. I pity the lawyer that has to cross-examine this one. Let's check. There's a screwdriver stuck in this drawer. I wonder what's inside. Let's take a look! Hey! What are you doing? Not touching. She's twitching here. This is a sign. Hmm. No clue. Bad boy. You really shouldn't pry around in other people's rooms now. You wouldn't want to make me upset, would you? Upset? I thought she was going to explode for a second there. I wonder what could be inside the drawer. Maybe later, yeah, maybe. The flowers are fake, as expected. I know sunflowers and tulips, but that's about the extent of my floral knowledge, yeah. Still seen painting, wait, should that be still alive? Whatever, one of those is hanging on the wall, okay, okay. That's a huge bottle of champagne. Sugar daddy? The late summer sunlight streams through the window. There's the Fay and Cole offices building, of course. You can see the inside of the room pretty clearly from here. I think it would be a little difficult to recognize a face from this distance, though. A bottle and two glasses. Somebody must be staying with her. I bet. It's been recently made, nothing eye-catching. Let's see. Damn it. Okay. No. Talk. I see there are two glasses on the table. Is someone staying here with you? What amazing powers of observation. What amazing powers of observation. You must be one of those famous detectives like on television. The screen of the text is always blocking out their personalities. This must be patched. Okay, moving on. Oh, no, no, not me. I am just a lawyer. Same as the big detective. Why don't you go look for clues in the garbage, hmm? Miss May doesn't like nosy little lawyers, hmm? So she's talking of herself in third person. No sane person ever. Okay. Oh boy. Yeah. Let's see. Do you think you could tell me something? I need you to describe what you observed at the time of the incident. You sound just like a lawyer in the movies. Or like a man with a big... vocabulary. And I like a girl with a big personality. Okay. Better not encourage her. Yeah. You know that thing that occurred happened the other day, so we're now using simpler vocabulary. She's not the brightest candle on the cake. Okay, so What happened the other day? The bad thing. The bad thing. What did you see when it happened? I don't suppose you could tell me about it. Pretty please. Let me see. Well, dream on. Okay, if you want to know, you'll just have to come to court tomorrow, Mr. Lawyer. 10 a.m. Oh boy, Miss May. She's... Never mind, never mind, never mind. Okay, could you just... Who exactly are you? Oh, Mr. Lawyer, are you hitting on me? Yeah, yeah. No, hey, I'm just doing my job here. Teehee. You know, you're cute when you blush. Believe me, this is the first time in my life I've blushed this much. Yeah. Right. Can you just tell me what is it you do? Well, no. And you had your little hopes up, didn't you? Oh boy, yep. Okay. Let's see. Can we move? No, we can't examine anything else in here. The screwdriver she gets upset with us. We had this checked. The champagne, the two glasses. She's not telling us why and who's staying with her. The bait has been made recently. And you can see the lawyer's office, but not faces. Okay. Let's move. Let's see if he's back in the office. Can I? Seems like Mr. Grossberg is out. Ah, maybe we just wait for him. If that wasn't the most over the top clearing of the throat I've ever heard. There he is. Okay. Okay, never mind. We'll get to this schnauzer and this one, this whatever. No. Werde ich nicht. Werde ich nicht. Ich habe eine 2080S. Also für, keine Ahnung, 900 Euro. Ich denke nicht. Okay. Ja. Yeah. Das bringt es halt einfach nicht, finde ich. Es war sehr verlockend, eine 3080 für was, 600, 700 Euro. Aber, weiß ich nicht. Die 2080S kriegst du dann eh nicht mehr verkauft, sobald die draußen ist. Wenn die so viel stärker ist für so viel weniger Geld. Also kannst du das auch knicken. Ja, noch. Noch kriegst du es verkauft. Aber was hast du dann in der Zwischenzeit? Obwohl, wann ist der Release? 20.09. oder so. Keine Ahnung, habe ich mich noch nicht so beschäftigt mit, ehrlich gesagt. Ja, ich habe keine Übergangsgrafikkarte, das wäre nicht so schlau von mir, glaube ich. Ich habe meine alte verkauft. Meine 1080. Muss ich mir nachher mal überlegen. Ich mache jetzt erstmal noch ein bisschen die zweite Episode weiter und dann gucke ich mal. Wird das wahrscheinlich als Let's Play dann einfach cutten. Kann ich das rausschneiden gerade. Auch wenn irgendwas ist oder so, schreibt mal bei Steam. Steam. Steam klingt gut. Muss ich nur noch den Ton ausmachen. Ich guck mir das nachher mal an. Mal schauen. Um. So, weiter geht's. Okay. Oh, yes, that's me. He looks even grander than I imagined. Okay, let's see. That badge on your collar. This one. So you're a lawyer. Ah, the lawyer badge. Okay. So you're a lawyer, are you now? Yeah, well, yes. And what do you want? I'm not particularly busy these days. Please proceed. Not busy, then how come no one could get in touch with you? Something the matter? You came to see the one and only Marvin Grossberg, didn't you not? Didn't you not? Did you not? Well, here I am, boy. What do you want? Out with it. Oh, actually, it's about Maya Fey. Yeah, well. Ah, yes, Maya Fey. Go on. Why did he react so weird? I'm calling it now. He's the murderer. Murderer. He's the murderer. He's the murderer. I'm calling it. First try. We'll nail him. Why the strange reaction? Ah, cha-cha. What? I'm really quite busy here, son. And can't go taking cases on a day's notice. No, it's quite impossible. Wait a second. How did you know the trial was tomorrow? Yeah, exactly. What's up with that? Anyway, I'm afraid it's entirely impossible for me to represent her. Sorry, end of discussion. You can't represent her because you murdered the sister, you weirdo. Let's go. He refused me before I even got a chance to ask him. What do I tell Maya? Can I examine him? Nope. Okay, move. No. We don't want to move away. We want to talk to him about your refusal, Mia. Let's lure him into. It's quite a painting. Ah, you notice. It's my pride and joy. Impressive, isn't it? Well, isn't it? Okay, the color of the sky, the hue of the sea, the weave of the straw hat. It's worth at least 3 million. I have no intention of parting with it, of course. 3 million. Yen? Dollar? No, I won't sell it. Not even to you. It's not for sale. I'm not buying. What the f. Let's talk about Mia, man. How did you know Mia Fey, bro? She worked here a long time ago. Quite the apprentice, that one. Learned my techniques in the blink of an eye. He killed her. She left one day, quite suddenly. She had a mission, you see? A mission. You could see it in her eyes. She followed it with a burning passion, never looked back, that one. How can you just refuse like that? Please tell me why you won't take the case. Well, you see, it's just I'm busy, you see. But the client is Mia Frey's sister. Mia trusted you. She knew her sister would be in good hands. Yes, of course. I know that. However. Okay, I'm sorry, but I must refuse. Sorry, goodbye. Creep, fine. I don't have time to argue with you anyway. I'll go look elsewhere. Think not. Huh? Think not. Did you say something? I think not, I said. What do you mean? I'm terribly sorry, but I'm afraid that no lawyer worth their salt will take on this particular case. When Mia told her sister for a future case that will make a lot of buzz. Did she mean the case of her murder? Or the case of the evidence she was keeping and hiding for at her sister? Terry saw my boy. Why? I cannot say. I beg your pardon, but could you leave now? Could you leave now? I have nothing much to discuss with you. What's going on here? Yeah, exactly. What the fuck is going on here, man? Okay, let's move to the detention center. Let's go. Yeah, bad news, bruh. Bad news, bruh. Hey, oh, you're back. Did you find the lawyer? Yep. Well, see. I really don't think you should use that guy. He didn't seem healthy. He wasn't all skin and bones. Yeah. What really happened? You don't mean he refused to help. I see. I've been abandoned then. Yep. What about your family? I only have my sister. My father died when I was very young, and I don't know where my mother is. Okay. So she could still be alive. Your mother. The woman in my family and the women in my family have been mediums for generations. They say a lot of spiritual power runs in our blood. About 15 years ago. I'm so sorry. Our family was involved in an incident. There was a man and he ruined our mother's life. Did he rape her? Ruined? After that, she disappeared. Several years after that, my sister announced she would become a lawyer and she left the mountain. So you live by yourself? Yep. I've gotten used to it. Oh, also, I had to become independent or I would lose my powers. I feel bad for her. Bro! Sorry, I'm yawning, man. I was working early hours today. I feel bad for her, all by herself up on that mountain. What mountain? Your mother's enemy. So, who was this man who ruined your mother? About 15 years ago, there was an unusual murder case. It made quite a stir. Everyone was talking about it, apparently. The police were running out of leads, and they were getting desperate. Wait, they didn't use the spirit medium, did they? The police convinced my mother to try to contact the victim. Wow. So what happened? The case was solved. You thought. You thought? The man my mother helped, the police captured. The man my mother helped, the police captured, was innocent. The police's consultation with the medium had all been carried out in secret, of course. But a man found out about it and leaked it to the press. He told all the papers that my mother was a fraud. Holy shit. It was a fraud, and the media jumped on it big time. She, my mother, became the laughingstock of the nation. I see. White. Excuse me, White? That was his name. My sister told me. White? Just a little longer now before the state appointment. State appointed lawyer comes, I guess. 4 p.m. Time's up. What should I do? Do I just leave her and go home? Nope. We're defending her. I've made up my mind. I'm going to defend you, whether you want me to or not. Why? Well, someone else is the culprit. I don't know why. I can't abandon you. No one is as sad as a person without any friends. I know. I've been there. A long time ago. Why did I become a lawyer in the first place? Because someone has to look out for the people who have no one in their sight. On their side. Maya, I want to burn it. You can count on me. Bruh. That's so kind of you. I don't know if she's crying because I'm not ready for the case. Or if she's thankful. Well, let's fight this one and get you out of here. Right, thank you. Wait, she smiled at last. She looks like an entirely different person. One last question. You're innocent, right? Yes. Why? And I trust you. So, you trust me too, okay? It's a deal, so what next? There's something that's been bugging me. Just what was inside that strange woman's drawer? Yeah, exactly. A screwdriver. It was when I tried to look into the drawer that she got all defensive. There has to be something in there. OK, Okay. We're done talking. Wir gehen wieder zum Hotel. Meaning, we're going back to the Gainwater Hotel.